Act 1. Julio Cesar Chavez steps up in weight to make his super lightweight debut. It was 1984 when the then 22-year-old Chavez captured the super featherweight crown in spectacular fashion. 3 years later, he destroyed Edwin Rosario to become the world lightweight champion. Some consider Chavez the most effective fighter in the world, regardless of weight class. Tonight, he pursues his third world title. Act 2. WBC super lightweight champion Roger Mayweather is introduced as the so-called Mexican assassin. In Los Angeles alone, Mayweather has defeated his last six Mexican opponents. Tonight, he vows to make Chavez number seven. In the final act, their paths cross again. When first they met in 1985 as super featherweights, Chavez needed only two rounds to dispose of Mayweather. Tonight, both seek revenge. Mayweather for himself, Chavez for his Mexican countrymen. Stay tuned as the curtain rises on the rematch as HBO Sports presents the WBC Super Lightweight Championship battle between Roger Mayweather and Julio Cesar Chavez. So tonight, World Championship Boxing comes to you live from the Forum in Los Angeles. Los Angeles, the city which is itself the ultimate forum for the presentation and recognition of star quality, where tonight you will see a legitimate star boxer, Julio Cesar Chavez, as he goes for his third world title, the WBC Super Lightweight Championship, which presently belongs to Roger Mayweather. And we will have an enthusiastic fight crowd inside the forum for this bout. Hello again, I'm Jim Lampley, and I want to begin this telecast by saying that we will not be accompanied tonight by our regular HBO boxing expert, Ray Leonard. Ray is in Florida preparing for his upcoming date with Thomas Hearns. And Ray, we know you're watching, we miss you, we're thinking about you. In the absence of Ray Leonard, I'm working, of course, as always, with HBO boxing analyst Larry Merchant. And Larry, our opening referred to the fact that when these two men fought 4 years ago, it was a relatively easy two-round knockout for Julio Cesar Chavez. Realistically, does Mayweather have a better chance tonight?
Realistically, when great fights good, great usually wins. And of course, it's Chavez who has the look of greatness about him. The case for Mayweather is this. He has in the past had extreme difficulty making 130 to 135 pounds. So probably the added poundage tonight will benefit him more than Chavez. Even Chavez admits that. And beyond that, Mayweather also has bulked up his confidence by staying active. 15 fights since that knockout, winning six of them over Mexicans with similar styles as Chavez, and winning a championship. We have two champions tonight, and when champions meet, we often get real fights. And that's what we're here for.
And indeed, because of his great success against Mexican fighters, Roger Mayweather has been dubbed by some the Mexican assassin. It's a nickname he himself does not prefer. He likes to be called the Black Mamba, a reference to one of the deadliest snakes in the world of reptiles. But why, by whatever nickname, Roger Mayweather has proven himself over his career to be an extraordinarily resilient and indeed a thoroughly professional fighter. Springtime in Georgia, where nature sings a sweet, sincere melody. But Roger Mayweather, the WBC super lightweight champion, has not come to Augusta for its serenity and peacefulness. He prepares for the biggest fight and biggest payday of his topsy-turvy career. Born and raised in Grand Rapids, Michigan, Roger Mayweather has been fighting since the age of nine. After being forced out of amateur ranks for using professional tactics, the young man with high aspirations made his way toward the glitter and glamour of Las Vegas. But where many fighters go to seek fame and fortune, Mayweather went as a tourist.
The only reason I really went to Las Vegas anyway, because I wanted to see Las Vegas. I wanted to see, wanted to often see that, see could I meet Dan Tanner, Lola Falana, you know, and I wanted to tell my friends if I did one thing in my life that I wanted to do, and that was to go to Las Vegas to see these stars. And that was the only reason I lined up in Las Vegas anyway.
He saw it. and then he stayed, and eventually met the transplanted Georgian, Billy Baxter, professional gambler extraordinaire, part-time fight manager.
I went to the gym one day, and this young kid was in the gym. He was just boxing, and I couldn't believe what I was seeing, so I asked somebody who this new fighter around town was, and they said, well, that's Roger Mayweather. We hit it off right from the beginning, really, and like I said, we both had the same goals in mind. I felt that he could become world champion from the very first moment that I saw him. And, of course, 15 fights after I got Roger, he fought for the world championship and he won his first title.
That first title shot was a thriller as the excitable fighter with the deadly right hand traveled to Puerto Rico and upset then-champion Sammy Serrano for the junior lightweight crown. 1 year later, Mayweather lost that title when he was knocked out by an up-and-coming Rocky Lockridge. 16 months later, another title shot went astray when Mayweather was defeated by Julio Cesar Chavez. But Roger Mayweather moved up a weight class, captured the super lightweight title, and has defended it 4 times. This is the kind of fight all fighters dream of. So for the transplanted odd couple, it was back home to Georgia and to Billy Baxter's plush 30-acre estate.
He's never really went to a real isolated camp to train for his fights, and probably some of the fights that Roger lost was really as a direct result of that. And we just felt that for him to get away from the bright lights in Vegas and really get away and isolate himself, we thought that this would be the place to do it.
Anything got to do with sports, I like. I'm really an athletic person. Even when I'm not boxing, I'm always doing something athletic. So that's why this was a perfect surrounding for me.
President Woodrow Wilson said, "The man who is swimming against the stream knows the strength of it." Only Roger Mayweather knows the toll that 39 fights have taken on his body. He's quite aware that in the past, his chin has been regarded as suspect. He well knows the skills of Julio Cesar Chavez, but the Black Mamba persevered, trying to gain the respect that is accorded to champions. Inconsistent in the ring, Mayweather is constant in his dedication to young fans and younger fighters, his desire to give something back to those who have supported him.
The reason Roger Mayweather gives back to the kids is because I was once a kid. I know what it is to be loved. I go back to Michigan, I look and I say, well, I made it out of here. You can do it too. So it's an encouragement to them.
No one knows for sure what's in the cards for the unheralded champion from the North, whose career is guided by the high-stakes gambler from the South. But you can bet the house that Roger Mayweather will give his best to uphold his identity as the assassin of Mexican fighters. And now we bring you back live as coming up on HBO Sports, from the Forum in Los Angeles, California, HBO's World Championship Boxing presents the WBC Super Lightweight Championship fight between title holder Roger Mayweather and the man who holds 2 lightweight championship belts, Julio Cesar Chavez in Mexico. And once again, I'm Jim Lampley with Larry Merchant. Larry, what we're here to watch is another chance for Julio Cesar Chavez to underline the status that many accord to him as best fighter in the world outside of Mike Tyson, maybe even best fighter in the world pound for pound. What are the dangers which face Chavez here?
Well, for one, there's Mayweather's right hand. He can punch, and sometimes the lion does get gored by the buffalo. But there might be some other dangers, if they can be called that, in the atmospherics around the fight. Chavez normally is the most focused of athletes, and yet he admits that he's been a little distracted by some financial hassles he's had with promoters. In addition to that, he's winning recognition as the best fighter, at least south of Mike Tyson and Ray Leonard, and it's hard living up to the expectations of that in every fight. And finally, he has been busy outside the ring with his own agenda. Although he is a champion and a hero in his country, Julio Cesar Chavez wants something only one other Mexican athlete has achieved. Fernando Valenzuela, in a big league baseball uniform, has been a cross-cultural star and a major box office attraction. but it's very hard to make the leap from foreign champion to American star. In recent decades, only Roberto Duran and Alexis Arguello have done so. Besides that, despite all the many Mexican boxing fans in Los Angeles, there hasn't been a big fight here in years. LA has other things on its mind. Still, as Truman Capote said, a boy's gotta hustle his book. Chavez is out here among his people selling the fight. Despite the obstacles that Los Angeles presents, the brilliant and personable Chavez feels that his magnetism will translate into America. That has become as important to him as the fight itself.
I think that if there's one man in the light of the visions that could fill up the form, that's Julio Cesar Chavez, especially against Mayweather.
There are 4 million reasons for such expectations. That's the estimated Latin population in Southern California. People who know what it means to fight to make it.
I've sold out fights in Las Vegas, and I've sold out fights everywhere I fought. With my people requesting me to fight here, I feel the same thing will happen at the forum.
Mexicans and Mexican-Americans are the principal supporters of boxing here, and Chavez is the kind of fighter who embodies their spirit and hopes with his aggressive style and his Ray Leonard-like public charm.
Word's out. The real boxing fans know about this fight, and the real boxing fans in Los Angeles are predominantly Hispanic. And I know they're excited, if for no other reason than to see Roger Mayweather lose.
True fans are, in a sense, true innocents as well as true believers. So Mayweather's 6 straight wins over lesser Mexican fighters than Chavez still have Chavez's fans demanding vengeance.
Mexicans are rooted in bravery. We are real men. Fighting and honor are in our blood forever.
For those who don't have it in their blood, Chavez has been doing whatever it takes to spread the news of the fight, trying to reach out to fans who are connected to him, not emotionally, but through his TV image as a dominant athlete.
Whenever I go through the streets of LA, everyone stops me and says, attack him on all fronts, break his head open, knock him out. I will try to accommodate the entire public here in Los Angeles.
Just in case Los Angeles couldn't get excited about Chavez Mayweather, Don King briefly toyed with the notion of a Mike Tyson exhibition on the undercard.
It's not an insult, but I do not think I need Mike Tyson to fight my battles for me. I want nothing to do with exhibitions, so it will be seen who the people are that I bring in.
And officials at the forum expected a crowd in excess of 15,000. This place would hold more than 18,000 for boxing. 15,000 plus would be the biggest crowd here in 17 years. It does not look that full, Larry.
It's a big crowd. It will be a passionate crowd, although it isn't what they expected or hoped for.
Most of those in this crowd will feel either a national or cultural affiliation with the man who comes out right now, holder of both the WBA and WBC World Lightweight Championship belts, moving up now to a higher weight class, Julio Cesar Chavez. Last victory over his countryman, Jose Luis Ramirez, back in November. There is his record in championship fights. That is but a subset of his overall record, which you might see as the most remarkable current record in the sport. Julio Cesar Chavez has had, by our official count, 60 fights. He has won 60 fights.
You figure somewhere along the way a fighter is going to run into a punch, but Chavez has never run into one he couldn't handle.
So Julio Cesar Chavez prepares to match up 4 years and 10 pounds later against a man he's already beaten once. And we go now to Larry Merchant's head-to-head tip of the night.
So here's a preview of what we might see tonight. Roger Mayweather has to keep pumping that left hand, but he must not drop it because, as you saw there, Chavez will go right over the top. He must also throw more than those 1-2 combinations. He likes to throw the left followed by the right. He very seldom comes back with more. And finally, he must concede occasionally that you have to tie Chavez up rather than always punch at him when he comes at him. Chavez must get inside, and he must move his head to keep avoiding the counterpunches of Mayweather. He especially has to be aware of Mayweather's very good right hand. He was hurt by that right hand in the first fight. And finally, he must assume that this will be a different Mayweather, that he won't fall over as easily as he did in their first fight.
And the boos you hear in the arena greet the entrance of the man whom Mexicans see as the Mexican assassin, a man who's built much of his career by knocking off Mexican fighters, Roger Mayweather.
And wearing that Mexican costume is sort of a good-natured taunting, or some people may take it as a fella sticking his head into his opponent's face.
Well, it's a bit of a perverse relationship. They boo him, they root against him, but they don't dislike him. They know he's done a lot for the identity of Mexican fighters and for the boxing business in this town.
They respect him.
The record, 34-5, 23 KOs, mostly with solid shots off that great right hand. And there goes the sombrero into the crowd. And as Mayweather dances, we look at the tail of the tape. And you can see that Mayweather, regarded as the more comfortable at this weight, came in 1¼ pounds under the limit. It is Chavez, perhaps a bit surprisingly, who tipped the scales at an even 140 pounds. The reach advantage, to the degree that that figures at all, belongs to the classic boxer, Roger Mayweather.
And I suppose what some people wonder is whether at that weight, Chavez will still have the quickness for which he is noted. And here is our punch stat, which is a statistical profile of how active fighters are. There you see Mayweather in his fight against Vinny Pazienza, throwing 40 punches around and landing about half of them. Chavez throws more punches and lands a still higher percentage. And in the jabs, you see where the styles differ. Mayweather throws a lot of jabs. Chavez just uses the jab as a way to get inside to throw heavier stuff.
WBC rules are blended with California rules to govern this bout. Three judges scoring the fight on the 10-point must system. No standing eight count, no three knockdown rule, and you can be saved by the bell in the last round only. And right now, let's go up to ring announcer Jimmy Lennon Jr. for pre-fight introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you. Y a todos nuestros amigos latinos, bienvenidos aficionados al box. A very good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Great Western Forum in Inglewood, California, as Don King Productions presents the main event of the evening, the Fury at the Forum, the WBC Super Lightweight Championship of the World. This bout is supervised and directed by the World Boxing Council in conjunction with the California State Athletic Commission. Representing the WBC, President Jose Suleiman. Supervisor Haig Collegian. Representing the California State Athletic Commission, we have the Chairman Raul Silva, the Vice Chairman Jerry Nathanson, and the Executive Officer Ken Gray. Now presenting the officials as they are appointed. Judging at ringside from Los Angeles, California, Chuck Hassett. From Switzerland, Franz Marti. And from Hawaii, Tamotsu Tomihara. Introducing the timekeeper at the bell, also keeping count of the knockdowns, we have Aaron Coslow. And the ringside physicians, the legendary fight doctor from Los Angeles, Dr. Bernhard Schwartz, And from Beverly Hills, California, Dr. Robert Carnes. Presenting the referee in charge of this bout, Hank Ellisprew.
One up, two down.
All right, fans, here we go. The bout you've all been waiting for. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Super Lightweight Championship of the World. Introducing to you first, the challenger fighting out of the blue corner. Wearing white trunks with red and green trim, hailing from Culiacán, Sinaloa, Mexico. Weighing in tonight, an even 140 pounds, his outstanding record, 60 wins, no defeats, 50 big wins by way of knockout. He's currently the WBC and WBA lightweight champion of the world, presentando el gran campeón mexicano, Julio César Chávez. And his opponent across the ring, introducing the defending champion fighting out of the red corner. Entering the ring tonight, wearing black trunks and gold trim. Hailing from Las Vegas, Nevada, he weighs in tonight a trim and ready 138 and 3 quarter pounds. His fine record, 34 wins, 5 losses, 23 wins by way of knockout. He's the defending WBC super lightweight champion, known as the Mexican Assassin, Roger Black Mamba Mayweather.
Ready to go? Are we ready?
I know one thing for sure, Jim. We won't get a Mexican hat dance here tonight. It will be more like what Sylvester Stallone, who I understand is here, once called an Apache war dance.
And as we wait for referee's instructions, Jimmy Lennon Jr.'s dad, Jimmy Lennon, is one of the great ring announcers of all time. He's watching tonight, and I'm sure he's very proud of his son.
And if you close your eyes, you couldn't tell the difference between them.
That's a neutral corner, and this is a neutral corner. In case of a knockdown, the man go there and stay there until I tell you to come out. Okay? Good luck.
Referee Hank Ellisprew with the final instructions. The crowd jacks itself up another level in support of Julio Cesar Chavez, and Roger Mayweather is used to this. He has fought in these circumstances before similar crowds many times.
Rematches have a noble tradition in boxing and sometimes an ignoble tradition. Let's see what we get here.
In their first bout, Chavez was able to get inside Mayweather's jab easily. Mayweather has vowed that it won't be so simple this time around. Already you see the Black Mamba working behind the jab. Chavez misses with a wide left.
Mayweather is a textbook fighter. Straight left, straight right.
He'll try to keep Chavez away with that jab. If he wants to land it, he has to step up a little closer. Good right hand by Mayweather, but Julio Cesar Chavez has one of the best chins in boxing. He is willing to take punishment to dish out more of it. Just as an early estimation, Larry, Chavez does not look super quick at this weight.
I think it's a little early to tell because Mayweather is moving more than we've seen him before. He absolutely cannot move at this pace for 12 rounds. And let's remember that Mayweather probably won the first round in their first fight. The boxer usually has an advantage over the slugger or brawler early in the fight, all other things being equal, which they never are.
Kind of an interesting contrast early. Mayweather has thrown by far more punches, but it is Chavez who is the psychological aggressor, chasing Mayweather around the ring.
Mayweather showing more respect for Chavez's punching ability than he did in the first fight, with good reason.
Julio Cesar Chavez has not landed an effective blow in round one. Roger Mayweather has scored some with the jab. But it is Chavez who has been the aggressor, and he shortens the distance between himself and the Black Mamba with each passing sequence. Didn't hear the bell.
Tito Alba, who has been our Spanish interpreter for many fights over the years, recently was killed tragically in an automobile crash. Our condolences to his family. Tonight, Ruben Castillo, who himself once fought Chavez, will be our interpreter.
Keep your punches up. Throw. Everything's good.
A lot of money at stake here, Jim. Not only the $750,000 plus that each one will get tonight, but the winner has some big, big money fights ahead of him.
And not to mention the amount of money that manager Billy Baxter has put on his fighter Roger Mayweather with the Vegas books.
Billy Baxter is a known gambler, and he reported to us today that he won $137,000 in two poker tournaments early this week in Las Vegas, and that he put $25,000 on 6-1 odds on his fighter.
It was a very quiet minute between rounds in Chavez's corner, and Chavez has begun to connect now. You mentioned at the end of round one, he was shortening the distance between himself and Mayweather. That pattern continues now. As you watch Chavez, if you haven't seen him before, note his remarkable ability for ducking and slipping punches inside and then countering to the body and sometimes to the head. There's a left.
That left landed.
And this is what Chavez did to Mayweather in their first fight. He stood him up, and he's got him standing still on the ropes.
Mayweather has weathered that storm. He's just playing possum here. I guess one of the issues in this fight, Jim, is whether Mayweather has added weight to his heart. And he comes in with a good right-hand counter.
Keep in mind that Chavez has never felt the punches of a 140-pound fighter before. Will his chin be as good at this weight as it was at 130 and 135? That's one of the many questions that surrounds this exercise. Mayweather missed twice with the left, and Chavez missed as he stepped inside.
Now Mayweather is standing his ground as he did in the first fight and looking to counterpunch.
Both fighters landed there. Chavez with the left, Mayweather with an uppercut.
One thing we've noticed Mayweather doing, as we suggested in the tips of the night, Jim, is he has tied up Chavez a couple of times on the inside. That was a very good right hand high on Chavez's head.
And a right to the jaw. Chavez keeps coming forward. And second round comes to a close. We go to the corner of Roger Mayweather with trainer Jesse Reed.
You got an exchange with him in there, but you got to stay in the low angle. You know when you're in there doing this, you're a lot quicker. All right? Get that body whipping on both sides. Get that body whipping. When he gets close to you, he's trying to come over the top. That's all you got to remember. Roll it. Hit him with the right hand every time you roll it, okay? You understand me, Raj? Make him pay when he throws them right hands. They don't have to be hard. Just keep touching them.
More water in his mouth.
Okay, here is Chavez throwing that long left that he slowed Mayweather down but didn't seriously damage. This is the same punch from another angle. You heard in the corner what they're trying to do.
Get down.
Learning from the first fight,
they
are trying to counter Chavez's counter. Chavez throwing over the left jab with his right, and now they're trying to counter over that right hand.
And of course, Mayweather has already lasted longer with Julio Cesar Chavez this time around than was the case 4 years ago.
Put your holder. I'm going to call you for holder. Put your holder.
A leaping left landed by Chavez. Those look good, but Chavez is ducking the blunt impact of a lot of those punches inside. He's starting to get into Mayweather's chest a little bit. Like that. Chavez blocking and slipping again.
Nice, break it, step back.
And while Mayweather has been chopping away with the left, with the jab, and has scored with an uppercut or two, he has not yet had a chance to throw a right cross on balance. That's his best punch. Right hand landed flush on the jaw. But Chavez had trouble knocking out good fighters at 135 pounds. So there's little reason to suspect that he'll be a knockout artist at 140. Low blow. And Julio grimaced at that one.
Chavez is a textbook fighter, but that was not in the textbook.
Both fighters landing in this exchange. But again, Mayweather doing almost all of his damage with the left hand, not the right.
Just as Mayweather is trying to counter Chavez's right, Chavez is throwing more lefts. No dummy he.
And the sheer aggression of Julio Cesar Chavez begins to take its toll, and now Mayweather rallies again with the left hand over Chavez's right. Counting down.
You can win the exchanges, Roger. When you don't wait to see what he's going to throw. Beat him to the exchanges, okay? Beat him to the exchanges.
Yeah.
Inside, now you can beat this guy the way.
All right, Harold Letterman, how have you see the fight?
Well, Larry, I've got it 3-0 for Roger Mayweather, 30-27. I think he's fighting a very, very pretty fight. He's using a left jab constantly. He's keeping that left jab in Chavez's face and using nice ring generalship, moving side to side.
All right, Harold, you and I disagree on this one. I've given Chavez the last two rounds.
And gentlemen, I'm sure you both heard referee Hank Elespiro calling for the deduction of 1 point from Roger Mayweather for the low blow. So deduct a point on your scorecard from Mayweather in round three.
Mayweather is not only fighting a better fight than he did the first time, but clearly he is in better condition. And much of that has to be attributed, apparently, to the fact that he is more comfortable at this weight. Before their first fight, he says, he had to take off 13 pounds in the last few weeks of the fight. In the last few weeks before the fight.
This looks to have the makings of a long evening. He's going to need that conditioning. And there's the right cross. And an uppercut landed flush on Chavez's chin, but Chavez does not back up. Right hand from Chavez. Mayweather clowning just a little bit. We are midway through the fourth round.
But you're holding.
The left hand missed. Mayweather working behind the jab still, and Chavez just stalking relentlessly. Trying to leap in with lefts and rights like that. Going to the body.
The ability to take a punch largely is mental. So it is obvious here again that Mayweather is in much better condition physically as well as mentally for this fight.
Elisburu again warned Mayweather, this time for holding behind the head.
Low blow again.
Low blow again, Elisburu says. Mayweather flirting with another point deduction. Both fighters landing good punches. Mayweather landed a right hand. And they're yelling at each other. Mayweather just missed with what would have been a sensational right cross. And a rousing round four comes to a close.
As I said earlier, Jim, when two champions meet, we get real fights.
He says, don't yell. Don't get upset. Just keep fighting your fight. You are head on all parts. You are head on all guards. Relax your arms. You don't have to win by knockout. You just got to win. Don't force the fight so you don't get tired.
He hit him low.
Yeah, but he hit even that round low.
That doesn't make any difference. Put your holding, all right?
Watch the low blow. All right, Roger. When you make your pivots. Here, I'll get it. When you make your pivots, pop to the body. Now step to the sides.
All right, baby.
That last voice you heard was the trainer, Lou Reed, who once left Mayweather because he felt he was playing around too much and not training hard enough. And he's back with him, and he says that Mayweather is in the best shape of his life.
Now you're watching another one of Chavez's extraordinary skills. See how he will lean up on Mayweather, body him off inside, and do so in such a way with the shoulders and the arms as to create a punching angle. He's done it twice early in this round.
All right, break it, break.
And when you heard Julio Cesar Chavez's manager, trainer, Cristobal Rosas, telling him, you're ahead on all three cards. If you're new to boxing, it's important to recognize he can't know that for sure. The cards are concealed until the end of the fight.
Watch it low, watch it low.
Chavez stepping in now and landing with much more consistency than was the case in the earlier round.
All right, break it, break.
Short, direct punches.
All
Mayweather going back to work behind the jab. Chavez blocking most of them.
Break.
Julio Cesar Chavez has designs on bigger things, big money, and an even bigger weight class than this, perhaps, down the road, the welterweight division. He would like to score an eye-catching knockout here.
High break.
But he'll sacrifice nothing, I think, in his effort to win the fight.
He's in with the best possible Roger Mayweather, and that means he may not get a knockout. He may not even get a win. Right now, that's what he has to think about.
Well, this is a close fight.
High break it. Step back.
But in this round particularly, Mayweather seems to be receding into a little bit more of a shell. Mayweather's punches have not had sting in this round. Chavez is by far the busier fighter now. Whether he'll be able to sustain this pace remains to be seen.
What's happening, what makes it look good bad for the judges is like you'll...
All right.
What makes it bad... Listen to me now. I'm trying to give you some good advice, and I'm on your side. This is the man we want to whip. Now look at me as you're breathing. When you're in the clinches with him and you're holding and not throwing, he's winning points. Even if he's missing you, he's trying to come over the top. You've got to start flurrying your punches in there. It looks like he did at the end there. Bop, 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 bop. Don't have to be hard.
Get by the corner. They're late getting out, all right?
All right.
Don't love this, Montre.
You've got to start moving them hands inside.
Okay.
Vamos a empezar cada vez que tires combinación.
Throw combinations. Work inside.
Ya se la puse.
Okay, drink it. Your hands are too low. Keep your hands up.
And if you know boxing, you know that Ruben Castillo has thrown some pretty good combinations himself. Some of them against Julio Cesar Chavez. Like all of Chavez's opponents, he left the ring a loser. No disgrace in that. We're in the sixth round. It's scheduled for 12. Chavez continues to stalk. Mayweather continues to fling the jab. Little more energy now from the Black Mamba again. Good right cross. And now Chavez does a little clowning of his own.
Uncharacteristic for Chavez, who usually wears that implacable mask.
Leads you to believe maybe he felt it a bit.
Exactly.
Well, he admitted to us yesterday that Mayweather hurt him seriously with the right in the early part of round two of their first bout. Didn't stop him from knocking Mayweather out about a minute and a half later.
Break it. Break.
Chavez not as busy in this round as in the last. Some of that directly related to the fact that Mayweather has been more sprightly. Now Chavez lands a left and a right. And tries to back Mayweather up again against the ropes. But Julio looks a little tired to me at this moment.
This has been a very fast pace. And Chavez is the type of fighter who expends a lot of energy because he's always moving forward and making the fight.
And he's carrying 5 pounds more than he's ever carried in his boxing life. Doesn't sound like a lot, can make a big difference. Crowd picks up again as Chavez continues to step inside. Very close to hitting on the break, but he got away with it. Mayweather landed a right, but not as stinging as the one early in the round. Another very active, exciting round of boxing.
Championship stuff from both men. Let's see Chavez at work early in the round, in which he maintained the pace. But later in the round, Mayweather came back and landed a couple of good right hands. And then we saw that exchange, that brisk, effective exchange from both fighters at the end of the round. Harold, quickly your score.
Larry, I have it 58-55, 4-1-1 Roger Mayweather. I think he's doing a paintbrush job on Julio Cesar Chavez with that left jab. And every time Chavez gets inside, Mayweather seems to tie him up effectively or catch him with a nice uppercut.
I have the fight 3 rounds apiece. But remember that 1 point was taken away from Mayweather.
And our punch stat operators, Logan Hobson and Bob Canobio, pass along to me that in terms of number of punches landed, the bout is just about dead even. They have landed an almost equal number of punches in the fight. By that count, unofficial.
You remember earlier, Jim, I said that the boxer usually has the advantage in the first half of the fight. Let's see now if Chavez does wear down Mayweather.
Chavez has to some degree blunted the left jab as a weapon. He has for the most part stayed away from the right. And he has scored increasingly inside. I mentioned that I thought Chavez looked a little tired at the end of the last round. His corner men were said to say the same thing to him between rounds, warning him against dropping his hands. He did get hit twice with the right in the last round. Chavez now vintage Julio Cesar Chavez, making Mayweather miss inside and countering.
But Mayweather is countering effectively.
They are trading in there. This is man-sized stuff.
Break it, break it.
New to boxing, this is what is called infighting. Chavez is regarded as one of the very best in the sport at it. Mayweather is holding his own, but he lost his balance there. And I think it may be Roger who's run into a tired spot here. This kind of fighting takes a lot out of you.
The rest of this fight will be determined on guts, ambition, and will. And conditioning.
And the track record shows you that Roger Mayweather is a very good professional fighter. Julio Cesar Chavez has never lost. Jesse Reed carries Chavez halfway across the ring, and the crowd begins to erupt.
Roger, you gotta throw more punches. More punches. All right?
Now this is going to be a break for Mayweather if it takes a while to clean up the ring.
Outburst represents a certain nervousness on the part of Chavez's fans. He's getting a much tougher fight than they expected.
We're in the eighth round.
He's ahead by 2 points.
You're out of the corner. I just moved him out.
There is a left hook and a right cross early in that round. What do these two men have inside them?
There's a lot of debris in the ring. There is ice, there are cups, there are hazards. We might see some slipping now.
All right, break it. Break it.
And you're looking at Chavez going to work.
Break.
If someone goes down here, they will literally be on ice.
Mayweather's eye is cut. All of a sudden, Roger Mayweather has blood coming from a mouse underneath the left eye. And he begins to try to measure the right cross in hopes of scoring a knockout. And he's landed it twice in a row. Make it three times. Chavez stares at him and says, come on, try again.
And Mayweather seems to say, damn, you take a punch.
Mayweather getting a little wild, perhaps nervous about that left eye.
But I believe the cut is under the eye, Jim. I don't think it's in a dangerous place.
And Julio has a mouse on the bridge of his nose as well. And perhaps a little trickle of blood just inside it.
This is predator versus predator.
Good left hand by Mayweather. Chavez keeps coming. Mayweather's left eye.
Now I see that the cut is apparently on the eyelid. I think
eyelid
he has
cuts.
An abrasion below the eye and a cut on the eyelid. And remember, the doctor can stop the fight here in California.
Eyelid cuts tear like paper. Huge chunk of ice just hit the ring doctor in the back. You're looking at one of the best cutmen in the sport now, Eddie Aliano, just out of frame, going to work.
Even though it's a bad cut, they have to allow Mayweather to go on. He's fighting too well. He has
good
earned
decision.
This. But let's see if he gets desperate here.
Fury. Great right cross by Mayweather. Chavez walked right through it. Resolution of Julio Cesar Chavez. He won't be stopped from moving forward. They flurry again after the bell, third time in the fight.
Sit down, stay still, stay still. Stay still, stay still. Breathe deep. Brindy, you stay still.
Stay still, stay still. There's nothing. The cut is nothing.
That is nothing.
Stay still, John. I'm going to give you some water, okay?
He's got a bad cut. You can knock that guy out, Roger. Just suck it up.
Está todo metiendo ese error y le está metiendo esa mano. Vamos a quitarnos esa mano. Vamos.
Work inside. Work the hands. Throw the right hand. Let's go. Work the punches.
You heard the voice of Billy Baxter, Mayweather's manager, saying you can knock him out, which suggests the concern they have because of the cut over his right eye.
Round nine of a war at the Forum.
It doesn't get too much better than this, Jim.
And it's a city that cries out for more interest in boxing, a bigger boxing audience and boxing public. You have the presence here now of middleweight champion Michael Nunn, who will create a lot of interest in the next few years and may ultimately fight here in Los Angeles. Chavez is a natural for the Mexican audience. And this has been great stuff. Julio Cesar Chavez's first journey at 140 pounds. The stamina appears intact. Maybe no more punching power than he had at 135, but no apparent loss of power either. And Mayweather suddenly is not fighting back anymore. Chavez trying to target the cut over Mayweather's left eye.
Chavez is now trying to stay on top of Mayweather the way he did with Edwin Rosario to reduce his punching room and power, which is exactly the right strategy.
He's great at it, too. His great chin, his ability to slip punches, his constant aggression allow him to fight this way. Other fighters would place themselves in much more danger by doing so.
All right, don't hold, don't hold.
And it begins to look a little like the Rosario fight did in the late stages. But now Mayweather is resurging again. The memory.
Six, seven, eight, nine. I can't see him, man. Okay, what's your turn?
All right, you gotta quit resting.
I can't see him, man. All right. Look in the legs. Look in the legs, Roger. When you got him on the legs, just come out in the middle, okay? Yeah. Okay, baby? Come on. Come on, breathe deep.
Roger, you're going to have to stop this guy, man. You know that. They ain't going to give you this fight. But you're fighting good. You can stop him, but you got to back him up, son.
Harold, your scorecard.
Larry, I've got it 4-4-1 even, 85-85. I think Julio Cesar Chavez has taken the fight away from Roger Mayweather in rounds 7, 8, and 9 by staying on top of him and taking away Roger Mayweather's left jab. He just doesn't give Mayweather the room to jab that Mayweather needs.
And you heard Billy Baxter, the manager, telling Mayweather, you got to knock him out. So he knows that in a close fight, he's going to have a very difficult time getting the decision because of Chavez's activity, because he's always moving forward and making the fight. In a close fight, that kind of fighter will get the benefit of the doubt.
As Chavez tries to join a growing list of fighters to have won world titles in three separate weight classes, it's no longer a stunning accomplishment in the alphabet world of boxing, but it's still a very significant one.
What it means basically is that he ran out of competition at 130, he ran out of competition at 135, And now he's trying the 140 pounders.
And as you watch him at 140, you wonder how he will fare if he elects to try to go to 147 against a Marlon Starling or a Mark Breland. If he succeeds here, there will be at least one more 140-pound fight. In the last round, Mayweather threw only 44 punches. So his business is shutting down gradually. He's been a little bit more aggressive in this stanza. Chavez has 50 knockouts in his career. Only one of them came past the eighth round. The book is, when he gets this far, he's headed for a decision. The judges have never failed him.
Mayweather isn't going to win this fight playing this way. Perhaps he's just trying to get a breather in this round for one last heroic effort in the last rounds. But he can't win the fight fighting this way.
Now he needs to bring back some of what he had in rounds 1, 2, and 3 when he was so impressive with the jab.
And Chavez is such a master at cutting off the ring. He really doesn't let you fight that way.
Well, to a large degree, what we're watching here is the sheer imposition of will. Chavez has made Mayweather fight his fight in the last few rounds.
He has awesome will. It's very rare the kind of willpower you see in Chavez combined with his skills.
Break it. Break. Break.
Roger Mayweather is fighting valiantly. But at this moment, as Larry Merchant points out, he's losing.
Get the shine. Come on. Get the shine. Come on.
Ted looks okay.
Julio, así como ahora, siga presionando.
Keep putting pressure.
Hay que tirar para que se caiga de culo usted todo el round.
Keep putting pressure, go right at him this round. You gotta go right after him. Drink some water. Drink some water.
They have stopped
the fight. Crowd response came earlier than ours because we were looking at Chavez. Referee Hank Ellis-Burrow talked to Mayweather's corner, and it's over.
And Jim, I'm not 100% sure of why they stopped the fight. Obviously he has a cut, but the cut wasn't giving him a problem. I hate to say it, but I just think he didn't want any more of Chavez.
I think you're absolutely right. The position that Mayweather has assumed on his bench, the relationship he has with his manager and trainer would lead you to believe that Roger Mayweather said, that'll do. And now Larry Merchant goes into the ring as the celebration swirls around Julio Cesar Chavez. WBC World Super Lightweight Champion, champion now in a third weight class, joining among active fighters such as Sugar Ray Leonard and Jeff Fennec and a few others who've been able to accomplish this, Thomas Hearns, Roberto Duran, and some of the other greats in the history of the sport who've done it, included Bob Fitzsimmons and Tony Canzanieri and Barney Ross and the immortal Henry Armstrong, Wilfred Benitez, Alexis Arguello, Wilfredo Gomez. Add to that list now Julio Cesar Chavez. We take a look at the final punch stat count. You can see that they threw an almost equal number of punches. Chavez was able to land more, particularly in the last few rounds. And ultimately, it was his imposition of will on Mayweather, his ability to force Mayweather to fight his fight and to accept the idea that he would do so that made Chavez the victor once again. And now let's go live to Larry Merchant in the ring.
All right, we're here in the ring. A bit of chaos here. Roger Mayweather just coming over to congratulate Chavez. Chavez has a little bit of a cut on the inside of the bridge of his nose. A much tougher fight than you expected.
Sí, esta pelea era mucho más difícil que lo que pensabas.
La verdad sí, la verdad que no salí en mi noche.
To tell you the truth, it was a tough fight because this was not my night.
Iba a apretar en el onceavo y décimo round. Mayweather es un gran peleador.
He said Mayweather is a great champion, great fighter, and the fight was pretty even till now.
When did you know that it was going to be a lot more difficult than the first fight?
¿Cuándo supiste que esta pelea iba a ser diferente que la primera?
I don't know, la verdad. Estuve psicológicamente aislado de esta pelea.
He was psychologically defeated and well down on for this fight.
Todo el entrenamiento no estuve concentrado en esta pelea.
And all of his training, he was not concentrated in this fight.
Tuve muchos, muchos, muchos problemas.
He had too many problems.
So you don't feel you gave your best effort?
Si no crees que tú diste lo mejor.
No, never. No di ni 50%.
He didn't even give 50%.
Did the extra weight bother you?
Si el peso excesivo
no, no te molestó. No. Les prometo que para la próxima pelea van a ver a un Julio Chávez diferente.
I promise for the next fight you'll see the Julio Chávez from before.
Este fue un reto para mí, la verdad.
What were the problems that you're referring to?
¿Qué son los problemas que dices?
I don't know, tuve muchos problemas psicológicos para esta pelea.
¿Pero cuáles problemas?
Pensaba mucho, mucho pensaba.
He was thinking too much. It was psychologically bad.
Did he ever hurt you because he landed some very big punches on you?
Nunca te lastimó porque sí tiró
mucho. Oh, yes. Me pegó como dos hechazos que me pega fuerte con la derecha.
He said, Roger hits really hard with the right hand. He hurt him a couple of times.
When did you feel that he was weakening?
¿Cuándo pensaste tú, cuándo supiste que estaba debilitando?
No sé, yo fui de menos a más. En el décimo round me sentía mucho más fuerte.
No, pero él.
No sé, él estuvo payaseando toda la pelea. Y no hizo una gran pelea. No peleó como debe ser.
Well, he couldn't tell if he was weakening because he was showing off too much. And he's not that type of fighter. He didn't come to fight him.
What are your plans now? Who are the fighters that you would like to meet next?
¿Qué son los planes de ustedes?
No sé, Don King. Quiero Camacho, quiero a Taylor, uno de los dos.
He wants Camacho or Meltzer Taylor.
So that you feel comfortable at 140 and you want to keep fighting at this weight.
¿Te sientes bien en 140?
Yes, yo creo que con esta pelea que hice que no me vi muy bien, Camacho va a querer pelear conmigo y lo estoy esperando.
He says he does want to continue this weight division. He knows that Camacho's watching this fight and he didn't feel good, so yes. Camacho will want to fight him.
Espero que Camacho ya no corra más, ya que pelee conmigo.
He says, Camacho, I don't want you to run
come
no more.
On, Camacho,
come on, fight me.
Finally, this question. Were you surprised that he retired in his corner because it didn't appear that the cut was bothering him that much?
¿Estás sorprendido porque dejó de pelear en la esquina, que pararon la pelea en la esquina?
Yo quería pelear, me sentía mucho fuerte, muy fuerte me sentía.
He said that he was surprised that he wanted to continue fighting because he was getting stronger and stronger.
He said that he had stomach cramps. Do you think he just had too much of Julio César Chávez?
Dice que tuvo calambres en el estómago. Si tú crees que tuvo muchos problemas con Julio César Chávez.
Yes, very good. Thank you very much. I love you. Oh, Estados Unidos.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. And now back to Jim at ringside.
All right, thank you very much, Larry. So we came to see another step in the genesis of the man many regard as the best fighter in the world, Julio César Chávez. It was, for the 61st consecutive time, a successful step. Right now, we go back to Jimmy Lennon Jr. in the ring for the official particulars.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of round number 10, the fighter unable to continue, the winner by way of knockout, the new WBC super lightweight champion of the world, Julio César Chávez.
It was an anticlimactic finish to what had been a dramatic and exciting bout. The two fighters were on their stools between the 10th and 11th rounds. As you were watching here on HBO, you saw the cut man in Julio César Chávez's corner working on the cut on the bridge of his nose. And there is Roger Mayweather at the moment at which he slumped forward on the stool as referee Lou Elispiro took a look, or Hank Elispiro took a look at his eye. And at that point, Elispiro turned around, waved his arms, and the crowd here, so much in support of Chavez, immediately burst into celebration as they knew that their man had won his third different world championship in a different weight class. Right now, Larry Merchant is standing by with the valiant but beaten Roger Mayweather. Larry?
Roger, you fought a brilliant fight. What happened? Why did you stop in your corner?
I got a bad cramp about the seventh round. I started feeling it coming on. So I knew I was fighting. They kept telling me to keep fighting inside, but I wanted to get out and use my leg a little bit because I know I could beat him from now. I could outpoint him from the outside. Hit him really easy. He's really easy to hit. But he got a tremendous chin. We already said that.
Where is the cramp? Your trainer is putting ice on you.
Right
in the pit of the stomach.
Right down by my
lip. Was it from punches that you took, or was it just from the activity and the heat of the fight?
Well,
where do you know?
Well, really, I think it's because I probably had too much liquid today, and it took toll on me, the liquid. But I came in rather light for the fight. I came in 138.
But you fought so well compared to the first time. Aren't you satisfied with that?
No, I'm not satisfied because I ain't a quitter. But I hit him with some tremendous shots. To have 140 pound would have went down.
Is that just discouraging after a while because he just takes such a great punch?
No, he wasn't really discouraging me, but he took a hell of a shot. I hit him with some of my best punches. And as you see, he took it and shook it off. He's not that great a puncher. He just he boy weigh you down. He's not a great puncher. A guy like a young fighter like Miller Taylor would give him a lot of trouble because he's not that big of a puncher at 140 pounds. He's just a weigh down.
But he's going to take a whole lot of beating to beat.
Well, he's going to take a lot of punches to get in. I think I hit him with some of my best punches. He stood up, so it ain't too many 140 pounds out there that can punch harder than me. He took it and he won victoriously, and he stopped the reign of the Mexican assassin. But I'll be back.
Thank you very much, Roger.
Thank you.
Again, back to you, Jim.
Thank you very much, Larry. It goes without saying that there may not be any other sports event, perhaps no other human endeavor, which is so naked and graphic a demonstration of will as is the sport of boxing. Tonight you watch two men of almost equal talent in the ring, one of whom simply has shown throughout his career that he will not lose, that given any chance whatsoever to impose his will on the opponent, to make the opponent fight his fight, he's going to be able to do it. Julio Cesar Chavez had trouble with Roger Mayweather for 7 or 8 rounds of this fight. But in the final few rounds, it had become clear that Roger Mayweather was going to fight the way Julio Cesar Chavez wanted to fight. And ultimately, that could redound to the advantage of only one man. So Mayweather drops to 34 wins, 6 losses, and Chavez's remarkable record goes to 61-0. Larry Merchant, if you can step down real fast, we've got about 30 or 45 seconds. Your final comment on what you saw and Chavez's future.
Well, I don't think there's any doubt that Chavez joins Mike Tyson and Sugar Ray Leonard as the premier fighter of our time right now, and that we're going to hear a lot more from him. It was a wonderful fight, and if that's only 50% of himself by his own estimation, I don't know if anybody wants to get in with 100% of Julio Cesar Chavez.
There are some very flashy and talented fighters in the 140-pound weight class, most notably Hector Camacho. You heard the discussion of him. Meldrick Taylor, regarded by some as having the fastest hands in all of boxing. Either of them would have a monumental test against Chavez.
That's right, and a fighter named Hector, and a fighter named Meldrick, and also there's a fighter named Purnell out there, Purnell Whitaker, a lightweight champion. So no Joes and Billies and Pugs, but some real good fighters, all of them undefeated, and this is the king of the lighter divisions. A lot of people have called this guy pound for pound. I don't know if I want to go that far yet, but he's enough fighter for me.
You can love watching him every time you watch him. And we hope to have more of him here on HBO. It's been a terrific reintroduction of the Los Angeles audience to big time boxing. Stay tuned immediately following this HBO World Championship boxing coverage for Trading Places on the East Coast and Shakedown on the West Coast. And now for Larry Merchant and Harold Letterman, I'm Jim Lampley saying so long from the Forum in Los Angeles. The executive producer of HBO Sports is Ross Greenberg. Tonight's fight was produced by Rick Bernstein and directed by Mark Payton. The feature producers were David Harmon and Brian McDonald. The replay producers, Michael J. Whalen and Steve Salvador. The assistant to the producer, Kendall Reed. The production manager, Russell Gabay. And the technical manager, George Winsell. We were